you can use AI to speed up your writing without sacrificing quality. I am an outliner, plotter, sometimes perfectionist kind of writer, but if you do any kind of outlining or pre-planning on your books, this could be helpful to you. Now, I'm not saying that I have a magical prompt that will make ChatGPT spit out a perfect outline for you, but this is how I use GPT-3 to help me outline faster and organize my ideas. Keyword here being help. So let's break down my different stages of outlining, and I'll give some examples on how I use GPT to help me get unstuck in certain places or to boost my idea output. My first step is always brainstorming. So I went into my work in progress outline with the major points of the story and a very solid grasp on what I wanted the first act of the book to be. So right off the bat, I gave ChatGPT all those ideas I had for the first act and asked it to organize that into a structured outline for the first act of the novel. So along with just being a quicker way to organize and format that messy outline that I had, some of its suggestions helped me see how I could put those pieces together in different ways and where I was missing some detail. At this point, I did not ask it for more content or detail. I was just asking it to organize what I already had. Another thing I did in this kind of brainstorming step was asking it for some ideas on the villain's backstory. And I ended up using part of one of its suggestions as kind of a jumping off point for this character's origins. Though a lot of AI suggestions on these kind of things can be pretty bland and stereotypical, it is helpful to just see one element of the story, such as a character's backstory, listed out in a bunch of different directions that you could take it. Even if you're only taking a little piece of something that it suggested, it's still helpful to just get your own ideas going and kind of give you a jumping off point. Going into outlining this project, Act 2 was the most fuzzy for me, so I ended up asking ChatGPT, what are some options for challenges or obstacles that the characters could face in Act 2 of this story? Something that forces them to work together as a team and has higher stakes. So in this case, it gave me one suggestion that I really liked, where the characters would end up stranded in an unknown part of space, so I asked it for more ideas using the same concept. And though I didn't end up using any of its exact suggestions from that prompt, it did give me some ideas on how I could pull earlier threads from the plot through the middle, kind of to the end of the story, so I added those in too. Like I said, I didn't use its exact suggestions here, but I did kind of take the formula and adapt it to be my own. At another point, I asked it to give me a 5-chapter outline and gave it a list of events that I wanted to happen to see what that sequence could look like if I were to outline it more detailed. Now, of course, it didn't have the context of my entire outline. I'm just asking for bits and pieces as I go. So it doesn't have the context of the rest of my outline, the characters, and my plans, especially for the ending of the book. Some of the details that it suggests don't apply, but even then, I found this useful to sort of find out the pace of this part of the story. So my second outlining step is just taking my pages and pages of notes and filtering them down and organizing them into each chapter. After that, I like to get about a paragraph of detail for the events of each chapter, basically just connecting all the bigger pieces and turning it from about like a 20-point overview outline into a more detailed chapter by chapter breakdown. For this step, I used ChatGPT very little, but I did ask it for some name suggestions for things like characters and places within the story, and I struggled to come up with even working titles, let alone real titles, for books, so I asked it for some suggestions and lists of sci-fi related words. I actually came up with a series title that I really like, which is Astral Relics, but GPT also suggested some kind of silly subtitles that I'm just using for fun, Through the Event Horizon, a totally accidental wormhole. Probably won't be keeping either of these, but they're just for fun. After I've got most of my chapters figured out and in the right order, I move on to kind of the expanded outline. And for this one, I use GPT to help me answer questions of how and why. I find it very difficult to write a chapter if I don't have these two questions answered beforehand. So in my first chapter, for example, I knew what I wanted to happen, but I didn't have a good reason for the character to be in that situation in the first place, so I asked GPT for some suggestions. And again, even though I didn't use exactly the suggestion that it gave me, it was enough to inspire the type of situation I was looking for, and I came up with something that I really, really love. And this was my process for a lot of chapters and scenes throughout the story, where I knew what I wanted to happen, or I had most of the pieces in place, but I wasn't exactly sure how to connect them. GPT spits out a lot of stuff that is just not going to work for you, but I kind of use it as a name generator / sounding board / brainstorming tool. And for that purpose, I think it is actually really useful and helped me write this outline much quicker than usual. I also want to offer an alternate way to use GPT in the expanded outline part of this method. If you want GPT to do more of the plotting for you, you can also do that. But of course, obviously use it at your own risk. I am not a lawyer nor the plot police, so this is just how I can see tools like this being used and my kind of experiences with the process. You can take your basic idea for a chapter or even a section of a story and just tell GPT to run with it and see what it comes up with. You can do this with basically no detail if you want to. You can give it one chapter idea and then say, outline the next chapter, and it will do that. You might not like what it gives you, but it will do it. Now, if only I could find an epic new adult fantasy adventure with sarcasm and battling the undead and a no-spice romantic subplot. Oh, hey, there's one. Revenge of the Druid Queen is out in ebook and paperback October 24th, coming to an Amazon near you. All right, that's all I got for you, so thanks for watching. Bye.